Namaste. Welcome to episode 3 of Logistics This Week, the series where I bring to you important news and its likely impact on the logistics sector. This week saw the inauguration of the India Maritime Summit, where the focus on the maritime sector was further endorsed by our Prime Minister, Mr. Narendra Modi. A key announcement was the plan to operationalize 23 waterways by 2030 as part of the Maritime Vision 2030. As a result, there is a lot of thrust on developing Indian inland waterways, which will help in improving connectivity to enhancing the reach to cities like Prayagraj, Varanasi, which though is landlocked, are open to rivers. This move will help reduce overall logistic costs, since the cost of moving cargo through waterways is only 1.08 per ton per kilometer, as opposed to the ₹2.58 per ton per kilometer by road. With the logistic costs reduced to half, massive economic growth can happen, or it is possible in these cities in future. The Shipping Secretary has mentioned that the government is looking at an expected investment of 2 lakh crore on 400 investable projects, which will be deliberated during India Maritime Summit. This is an attractive proposition for any private investor, given that India is looking at a big time growth in export. However, to see this kind of growth, there need to be infrastructure and port development, especially due to the fact that the exit point from our country or the port is going to be a crucial factor in creating an alternate supply chain for the world in near future. The deal of the hour is enhanced productivity and increased infrastructure and port efficiency, which can come through privatization. India is looking at bumper crops this year, which will result in major commodity movement to the Far East and to Europe. India's rice export to China is expected to be 16 million tons, which is double that of last year. And banana will be exported to Europe via sea route from the south of India, and our neighboring countries are planning to procure more cotton from India. This higher demand for agro commodities will also result in more export movement, which will also ensure that the export freight rate stays strong throughout this year. That's it. The pressure on the freight rate last year has raised the cost of Indian exporters, and further growth in freight rate can adversely impact our export orders. I personally hope that the balance of trade and availability of containers will be resolved by the second quarter, so that we can benefit from the increased export opportunities. All these news are indicative of significant growth for the logistics sector this year and point towards a sharp recovery from the slowdown we experienced in 2020. On that positive note, I have come to the end of episode 3 of Logistics This Week. Let me know your thoughts on the series in the comment section. And see you next Friday with more industry update and analysis. Thank you very much.